Hello, Windows Universe. In this video, we will talk about how to fix the error this app can't run on your PC in Windows. For a more in-depth look at the topic, we will link an article in the description down below. First, check if the program is meant for your version of Windows. Check if it's meant for 32-bit or 64-bit. Maybe you're using Windows 32-bit and are trying to unknowingly run a 64-bit program. This is very common, so check if you're running Windows 32 or 64, and then install the app for your version. This issue can also occur if you're trying to run some old 8-bit or 16-bit app on your modern 64-bit. It might have worked on a 32-bit operating system, but on a Windows 64-bit OS, it can only emulate 32 bits. Try a fresh download of the program. At times, the download can get corrupted. So, clear your browser cache and download and install the program again and see if it works. Log in with your administrator account if possible and see if you can run it now. You can also right-click on the item and select Run as an Administrator. You can also look in running the executable file of the instead of the shortcut. If the problem is happening when you're clicking on the shortcut, then let's try and open the program file folder, then find the exe file and try running it from there. We can also try and disable the smart screen. Now, this is a temporary workaround. You can disable your smart screen and see if it helps to do this. Let's go to search and look for smart screen. App and browser control. Look for reputation-based protection settings. And you want to toggle off, check apps and files, smart screen for Microsoft Edge, potentially unwanted app blocking, and smart screen for Microsoft Store apps. Then try running the program then. Now, make sure that you re-enable smart screen again, as this is a pretty good security feature. Next, we can try and sideload the app. If you downloaded the app package, but you didn't download it from the Microsoft Store, but from another source, and assuming you trust the app publisher, you might need to sideload the app. Now, just remember this. You should only sideload an app when you trust them completely. To do this in Windows 11, open Settings, look for Privacy and Security. Then, in the Security section, go to the Developers menu, locate Developer Mode, and toggle it on. You'll get a warning. Then click Yes. Then, try running the app then, see if it works. And finally, you can try and perform a clean boot and see if you can run it. If you can, then you'll have to manually identify and eliminate the offending process that's blocking this Windows app from running. Now, we did a video on how to troubleshoot in a clean boot state, and we'll include a link in the description.
For more helpful articles to help you maximize your Windows experience, go to our website, windowsclub.com. Do not forget to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel, where we are always adding new content aimed at making you the master of your digital house. Thanks for watching and have a great day.